In this session, session 5, you're going to learn all about Excel charts and graphics. So, what exactly is a chart? Here is some raw data, but most people find data easier to understand when it's expressed graphically as a chart. Here's a chart I've created from this raw data. And you can see at once from the chart that sales in Europe have slowly been increasing in the first quarter, while sales in the USA increased in February but decreased in March. When I designed this chart, I had to make 3 major design decisions. The first was to choose the chart type. I've chosen a column chart type. We'll talk more about chart types in just a moment. After I decided which chart type I wanted, I needed to turn my attention to the chart layout. The layout of a chart can be thought of as a list of the elements that a chart contains. We'll talk more about chart layouts and elements in just a moment. And once I'd chosen an appropriate chart type and chart layout, I needed to make one final decision: the chart style. That is, the colours and fonts used within the chart. Let's now talk in a little more detail about my first decision, the chart type. Here's the chart type I chose, the column chart type. But I could also have chosen a line chart type, or a pie chart type, or one of a large number of other chart types available in Excel. So once I'd selected an appropriate chart type, it was time to move upon the next stage in the design process and select my chart layout. The layout of a chart can be thought of as a list of the elements that a chart contains. Elements are artifacts such as the title element, the axis title elements, and the legend element. In Lesson 5.5, you'll discover how to quickly select a group of common elements for a chart, and then add or remove them one by one until you've got exactly the chart layout you need. When I'd finalised the chart type I wanted, in this case a column chart, and the chart layout, in this case I included elements such as the legend, title and axis titles, it was time to move to the last stage in the design process and select an appropriate chart style. Well, here's the chart style that I chose, but here's another style I could have chosen. You can see that both charts are of the same type. They're both column charts, and you can see that both have the same elements. That include the chart title element, the axis title elements, and the legend element. The differences in appearance, that is the colours, shading of bars, fonts used, and the position of the legend, are collectively referred to as the chart's style. You'll learn how to change a chart's style in Lesson 5.6. So now that you understand the 3 major design decisions involved in creating a chart, the chart type, layout and style, you're now ready to begin creating charts in Excel. And you've now completed Lesson 5.1. Understand chart types, layouts, and styles.